All right, fans, thanks for clicking on us here at Hens All Access. Kyle Coulter alongside head women's basketball coach Tina Martin. So, coach, team dropped a tough one tonight to Temple, 70-58. Second half kind of got away from you there. What didn't go right for you guys tonight?
You know, everything starts with defense. And I just felt like defensively, you know, we tried to block too many shots. We didn't – our rotation wasn't good. Put them on the line way too early in the second half. Kelsey Buchanan, who's our anchor, got in foul trouble. And then we had to play with two true freshmen in the back line, which is tough. You know, I thought we just took too many chances with the block shot attitude instead of playing fundamentally sound defense, taking some charges, and our rotation wasn't good. So we got a lot of things to work on. You know, with a young group, they're going to be really inconsistent. And unfortunately, that reared its ugly head tonight. We were very inconsistent with our rotations. We were very inconsistent fundamentally defensively. So we got to go back to the drawing board, and the first thing we got to do is play better defense and rebound the basketball.
Exactly, and you did have a couple bright spots. Two players had a double-double. Your two post players, Shanice Johnson and Kelsey Buchanan, discuss their effort tonight.
Well, you know, KB is our rock, and she can't get in foul trouble. I mean, I thought that really hurt the team when she went out. We got to find a way to protect her a little bit better, and she's got to play a lot smarter. She picked up that fourth one on a bad screen, which she never really should have set that screen. She's our leader, and so we need her on the floor. She was out for long stretches of time in foul trouble, and that can't happen for us. And then Shanice, you know, she's a young lady that's learning how to do some things, but the biggest thing right now with Shanice is that she needs to be in the right positions. I love her energy. You know, sometimes she gets tired out there, but she's not always in the right spot. A couple times tonight, she needs to remember where she's supposed to be. It's just a work in progress. But they both got double-doubles. That's great. But the bottom line is we didn't win the ball game. So everybody's got to improve. KB's got to stay on the floor longer. And Shanice just has to continue to focus and do the things to help us win ball games.
Thanks a lot, Coach. And Jen DeLuca is standing by with Shanice Johnson.
Thanks, Kyle. Here with Shanice Johnson. Shanice, didn't go as you planned tonight, but it's your first home opener at the Bob. How do you think it went?
Our team, you know, we're young, so we just had to focus on being consistent and boxing out and getting rebounds and crashing boards and try to prevent less turnovers throughout the game.
Looking forward to this weekend at Wake Forest, what do you think, you know, I know, what did you see today that was a little bit negative that you can turn into a positive for this weekend?
Definitely getting on rebounds. We need to bring more effort from the beginning. We definitely lacked a lot of effort. But as long as we stay focused and play as a team and go hard every possession, I think we'll be pretty good this year.
Well, career high of 14 points tonight. How'd that feel?
It felt great. You know, I love it here. I love the atmosphere. I love my team. I just try to do whatever it takes to, you know, help my team out and play hard and be a good player for Blue Hens. Go Blue Hens.
Well, best of luck Friday. Thanks, Shanice. The Hens return to action this Friday at 8 o'clock when Wake Forest is in town. The 2012-2013 CAA Championship team will be honored as their new banner is hung from the rafters. For head coach Tina Martin, Shanice Johnson, and Kyle Coulter, I'm Jennifer DeLuca. Thanks for clicking on us at Hens All Access.